dahil hindi ka nagko-cooperate dito sa pagdinig na ito, there is now a motion, a bond motion by Congressman Benny Abante to cite you again for contempt. And hearing no objections from the members of this committee, the chair rules that you are cited in contempt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. For the second motion, Mr. Chairman, I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the duration in which until the committee report will be adopted in the plenary, Mr. Chairman. And it follows that the investigation will be terminated, Mr. Chairman. I move that since the congressional facility for detainees is too crowded, I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the Women's Correctional Center. So move, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Please raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this congressional inquiry, so help you God? Yes.
Yes. Thank you, Comsec. Now to proceed, we'd like to acknowledge and recognize Congresswoman Jinky Luistro.
The committee is in receipt of the letter from Cassandra Lee Ong, represented by Attorney Topazo, claiming, among others, that her client opted to decline to testify, invoking the right to remain silent and or the right against self-incrimination. I deeply lament this action coming from the resource speaker, Mr. Chair, because we will remember that even prior to the creation of the Quadcom, various resource speakers have been mentioning already the name of Cassandra Lee Ong. And it is really unacceptable if we will allow in today's hearing that the resource speaker will remain silent, will not answer our questions under the guise of his right against self-incrimination. In the same letter, Mr. Chair, they even cited the case of violation of visa law of the Bureau of Immigration, as well as obstruction of justice, as the cases filed already against the resource speaker, making an impression, Mr. Chair, that we cannot raise questions to her anymore.
So please proceed, Congressman Dan Fernandez.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chairman. Cassandra, Cassie, kumusta ka na? Can you kindly remove your face mask?
Paige, can you please?
Maganda ka naman eh. Huwag ka nang... relax ka lang, Cassandra. You know, the reason why we invited you over, because if you remember, during the joint committee hearing, we invited you twice. And then, you never acceded to the invitation of the joint committee hearing. And then, we issued a subpoena. And then we elevated this issue on the Quadcom. You remember the time that you texted me, di ba? And eventually you call me. And the reason why I'm trying to tell this, Mr. Chair, during the time that we have conducted that committee hearing, that joint committee hearing, Cassandra, in the spirit of transparency, you know, Cassandra, no, I will tell the body, you know, that you texted me and you called me para at least malaman nila kung saan tayo magsisimula. But the reason why you called me is to ask for help kung ano yung dapat mong gawin. Am I right? You can answer.
Yes po.
Yes, and during our conversation, sinabi mo kung ano yung dapat mong gawin. Is this correct, Cassandra?
Yes po.
All right. And sa text mo sa akin, no? And I know that this came from your heart, no? Sinabi mo dito sa text mo na, "Hi Kong, thank you for the time to pick up the call. Sana matapos na po, puro na lang allegation. Pag-pray ko din po, maging fair enough din po. I'm not involved in politics and will not po. Ayaw ko din pong madamay sa away po ng malalaking tao. Mabuhay po ang Pilipinas. Mabuhay si PBBM." So you texted this, di ba? You remember? And you were saying na ayaw mo ring may madamay na sa away ng malalaking tao. Are you referring to sinong personality are you trying to imply on your text?
I invoke my right to remain silent po.
I invoke my right.
Yes po.
To your right. Okay. So kasi simple lang naman yung tinatanong ko kung sino yung mga ano to, malalaking tao ba ng mga Chinese o malalaking tao ng mga Pilipino? Mga politician ba ang sinasabi mong ayaw mo ma-involve sa away ng malalaking tao? You can answer directly, no? I mean, there's nothing wrong on saying, kasi sabi mo, Pilipino ka, di ba? And I will show you, Cassandra. This is the certificate of your naturalization nung papa mo. And we were able to get that during the time of 1978, he applied for the naturalization. And thereby, when you were born in year 2000, you are a Pilipina. Di ba? So, Pilipina ka. So, maaring sa dugo ay Chinese ka, pero sa puso at isipan, Pilipina ka. Am I correct?
Opo.
At saan ka madadamay ng mga away na sinasabi mo sa text mo sa akin? I never replied, di ba? Hindi ako nag-reply sa'yo eh. Because I really don't want you to answer back on my cellphone. What I wanted is for you to appear on the committee and to answer to all of us. So, sino?
Mr. Chair, I invoke my right po to remain silent po.
Congressman Fernandez, if
yes,
I may.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yung tanong ni Congressman Dan Fernandez ay hindi naman incriminating dahil ang tanong niya, kaninong away? Is that an incriminating statement?
Ang sinasabi ko po is right to remain silent po. Hindi po self-incrimination.
Mr. Chair?
Mr. Chair.
Okay. Congressman Akop?
I would just like to remind Madam Cassandra Ong and her lawyer that what we are conducting here is not a custodial investigation where you can invoke your right to remain silent. There have been Supreme Court decisions on this. So I think the witness has to answer. Otherwise, we will move to cite her in contempt for refusal to answer.
Mr. Chairman,
That is correct. Congresswoman Luis Tro, you want to...
Mr. Chair, the reason why I started our hearing with the parameters on the use of right to self-incrimination is to guide our resource speaker as to when they can be availed of and when they cannot. And as far as this representation is concerned, Mr. Chair, we have two elements before they can avail of the right against self-incrimination. One, there must be identifiable crime. And two, there is the probability that the resource speaker may be convicted of the crime. Now at this point, Mr. Chair, may we ask Ms. Cassandra Ong, nung tinanong ka ba ni Honorable Dan Fernandez, kaninong away ang iniiwasan mo? Ano bang krimen ang iniisip mo na baka ikaw ay madamay?
I refuse to testify. I refuse to answer po para sa own reason ko po.
If I may, Congresswoman Luis Tro, I'm sure it is upon the advice of your counsel, Attorney Tapacio, kaya mo sinasabi that you refuse to testify or the right against self-incrimination, etc., etc. Pero maliwanag po na marami pong sinight ng mga jurisprudence tungkol dito. And we are very lenient to your client, Attorney Tapacio. And because of that leniency, we allowed her to appear before us so that we can propound questions related to the alleged crime that she has committed. Under the jurisprudence that was cited by Congresswoman Luis Tro, meron pong identifiable crime. And we don't want the committee to be compelled to cite her in contempt. Because as it is, she is already detained in the House. And once the committee rules on citing her in contempt again, she probably would stay in this detention facility much longer. Kaya please, advise your client to cooperate. As long as her rights are not violated, we will continue to ask her questions. At yung mga tanong po na yan ay related po sa investigasyon na kung saan ay mayroon pong operasyon ng illegal na pogo dito sa ating bansa at si Cassandra Leong ang mukha o ang representasyon o representative nitong mga pogong ito. Kaya yun ang gusto po naming malaman, Attorney Tapacio. Please, advise your client. Yes, Cassandra, naintindihan mo ba yung sinabi ko?
Yes po.
Okay. So, sasagot ka na, Cassandra.
Mr. Chair, pwede po ako mag-excuse sa sarili ko ng like 10 minutes lang po.
Excused for 10 minutes? To consult with your lawyer? 10 minutes?
Yes po.
The Chair, is that too long? I mean, that's too long.
5 minutes.
You can consult any member you wish to consult. Kung yan ang problema. Kasi if we give you 10 minutes, alam mo, kanina pang umaga itong ating mga resource persons naghihintay.
Yeah.
Oh, in fact, we started 10 o'clock. Tuloy-tuloy po. At wag mo nang i-delay. Simple lang naman po yung tanong. Yung tanong po ay related po doon sa iyong involvement dyan sa Lucky South 99.
And Mr. Chairman, I think the resource person must consider na... Well, she's not special. Hindi po kayo lamang ang resource person that we are investigating. All of these resource persons have been here since morning. Lucky you are in your own room, di ba? Meron kang aircon, meron kang sariling kwarto. But all of these people who are working tirelessly to parrot the truth has been here for so long. We hope you understand and you're asking for 10 minutes for us to wait another 10 minutes. I think Mr. Chair that is unacceptable. And if I may can we ask Attorney Tapacio?
Yes, you may.
What's the reason, Attorney Tapacio, that you are asking for a 10-minute suspension?
May I address the chair, Your Honor?
Yes, please.
It was not my idea, actually, Your Honor. It was her request to me. And I told her to relay it directly because I cannot talk unless recognized. Thank you, Your Honors.
Thank you, Attorney DePascio. Congressman Fernandez, please proceed.
And, Cassandra, what is the reason for a five-minute suspension that for you to talk to your lawyer? Are you asking for a 10-minute...
Yes, po.
And what's the reason behind?
Mr. Chair.
Okay, sige. We will allow you for a 5-minute conference with your lawyer, provided that pagbalik mo, you will tell the truth. Is that clear?
Mr. Chairman, I object. Because we've been waiting here for so long. Let's start all this now.
I think the resource person needs to confer with her client. And the
Mr. Chair,
committee is
Mr. Chair.
About that. And well, because it is also her right, Mr. so Chair. We can provide her at least 5 minutes.
Mr. Chair.
May I remind our members that when the chair is speaking, let us not disturb him. That is the rule.
Thank you, Congressman Akop. Thank you also, Congressman Abante.
Well, so, Mr. Chair, I'd like to find out who is Congressman Akop referring to. I am one of the chairman of the court committee.
Yes, 1 minute suspension.
And I have the right.
1 minute.
Ota siya nag-away. Isi.
Hearing is resumed. You already had your 5 minutes, Cassandra. So please proceed, Congressman Dano
okay,
Fernandez.
I hope, Cassie, you know, you'll be answering all the query of all these members who are here. Precisely because you are a Pilipina. Pilipina ka. And I just want you to remind you, no? I'll show you some pictures, you know, Cassandra. Have you seen this? Nakita mo na ba to? These are all the torture victims na nakuha sa cellphone doon sa Porac at sa Banban. All those collected cellphones ay nakalagay itong mga pictures na to. These are victims of torture perpetrated doon sa Porac at sa Banban. Have you seen this? No, first time. Now lang. Okay. I will show you another picture. Ito mga pictures din. Ito naman yung mga namatay. They are 66 foreigners. Hindi makilala kung bakit sila namatay. Lahat sila almost all Chinese. Natagpuan sila almost everybody sa Region 3. So, nakita mo na ba sila? Hindi pa? Hindi pa rin?
Hindi po.
Okay. The reason why I showed you all these pictures is for you to realize the gravity of what you are into right now. Are you a incorporator of Lucky South 99?
Hindi po.
Hindi ka incorporator ng Lucky South 99? Never. Remember, you are under oath. Member ka or not? baka ina-advise mo, attorney, mali. Ha? Starting 2019, she is already an executive assistant of Lucky South 99. Cassandra, are you an incorporator of Lucky South 99 since 2019 to the present?
I think assistant lang po, pero hindi siya incorporator.
You are an executive assistant?
Tawag po dito, otori.
2019. Tama, Cassandra? Okay. Kailan ka naging executive assistant ng Lucky South 99? Kung pagbabasihan natin yung mga dokumento, November 2019, incorporated ka na doon. And you were like 19 years old during that time. Am I correct? Correct?
Yes po.
19 years old.
19 years old.
Paano ka nakapagtrabaho sa Lucky South 99?
Mr. Chair, I refuse po to answer.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair, point of order.
Point of order.
Well, what is the point of order of
the... Mr. Chair, I'm getting confused. With all due respect to Attorney Topacio, every time Chairman Dan gives a question, it seems that it's Attorney Topacio answering. So I think we should... No, I've been watching you and you've been whispering. So can we please give the resource person the opportunity to answer truthfully?
Attorney Topacio, may we ask you to refrain from answering in behalf of your client? As we clearly stated earlier, the role of the counsel is only limited to advising your client of his or her constitutional rights in this committee hearing. So, Cassie, ikaw ang sumagot. Okay?
Yes. Thank you. Attorney Topacio, with all due respect, I mean, I don't mean no offense to you, but it's just that let's allow the resource person the freedom to explain her side and to you know, explain how she's involved or not involved in this situation, because this is her opportunity to clear her name. Thank you very much, Mr. Chair.
Okay, Cassie, sino nag-recruit sa'yo sa Lucky South 99?
I refuse to testify po.
Okay, yun ang una mong ano, no? Yun ang una mong trabaho sa Lucky South 99?
I refuse to testify po. Sorry, Mr. Chair.
Tinatanong ko lang kung ano yun ang unang mong trabaho. Pwede mo naman sabihin iba ang trabaho mo, di ba? Anong unang trabaho mo sa buhay mo?
Pasensya na po ulit. I refuse to testify po.
Saan ka nag-college? This will not incriminate you.
It will po.
What? Ang tinatanong ko, saan ka nag-college?
I refuse.
Sabi mo Pilipina ka, 'di ba? Did you study in the Philippines?
I refuse po to testify po.
Attorney Topacio, let this be a warning to you to please allow your client to respond to the question. We will, you know, these are simple questions. Tinanong lang, saan siya nag-aral, saan siya nag-college? Right against self-incrimination? Please. This is a warning, Attorney Topacio. Let her answer. Kasi,
Mr. Chair,
ano mo lang, sagot mo lang ng tama ito. Dahil yung tanong na kung saan ka nag-aral ay hindi naman incriminating sa'yo. Bakit refuse to answer? Patipilitan kami, i-contempt ka.
So, Cassie, ang sabi ni Ronaldine Baterna, who happens to be in the Lucky South 99 and in the Whirlwind Corporation. Binigay niya yung mga cheque sa'yo at maraming milyon-milyon ang dumaang pera dito. So, ginamit mo yung checking account.
Pasensya na po talaga. I refuse to testify po.
Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair.
Yeah, we'll change na lang the question. If she feels that it will incriminate her. We will be...
of Congressman Fernandez. Yes, is this a short interjection?
Mr. Chair.
Please proceed.
I move to cite Cassandra in contempt.
Second.
There is a motion to cite Cassandra Ong in contempt for
Mr. Chairman,
violation of Section 11, Paragraph A and C of the Rules of Procedure Governing Inquiries in Aid of Legislation. Duly seconded. Do I hear any objections?
Mr. Chair. Apologies, Mr. Chair. This is not an objection, but just a manifestation. In the spirit of due process, may we ask that the witness explain why she should not be cited in contempt? If she has any reason
we'll
whatsoever.
We'll give her that privilege.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair.
Chairman,
we can also ask you to be cited in contempt and removed from this room if you continue to disobey the warning of the chair. So again, I'd like to make I'd like to ask the counsel, Attorney Topacio, do you understand the ruling of the chair?
Yes, Your Honor, I'm only advising her, Your Honor.
Make sure that you only advise your client, otherwise we will be compelled to remove you out of this room and
yes,
assign another lawyer for today's hearing for our witness, Ms. Cassandra Ong.
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you, maraming salamat. Please proceed, okay. Congressman Rog Gutierrez.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, I raised that point earlier because precisely I agree with the manifestation of Congresswoman Luistro that regarding the right, the invocation of the right to remain silent or right against self-incrimination is not absolute. Again, this is not a court of justice. However, given that we give deference to this right and we protect it, it must still follow the process, the due process provisions and rights that she may have. Given that, Mr. Chair, just to clarify po, when the right of against self-incrimination is invoked, first, there must be a specific identifiable crime, and second, that the witness is the one who probably committed the crime. To repeat, the question po, saan ka po nag-college? Now, Ms. Ong, through the chair, most respectfully, kindly justify your refusal to answer that question.
Again po, Mr. Chair, I refuse to answer or to testify po.
Then, Mr. Chair, I think the witness has chosen not to defend the question. And I believe the proper thing now is for the chairman to rule on the propriety of the invocation of the right against self-incrimination. And from there, I suppose, we would then vote on the contempt. Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Thank you, Madam Ong.
Thank you, Congressman Gutierrez.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Ako.
May I ask the resource person to repeat her answer to the query of the Honorable Gutierrez, I refuse to testify ba? Ang sagot po ninyo? Ha?
Testify po.
You refuse to testify. Yun po ang kasagutan ninyo doon sa katanungan po ni Honorable Gutierrez. So you refuse to testify. In other words, hindi ka na sasagot?
Opo.
Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair.
Just a intermain to that. Just an observation. Just an observation po, Mr. Chair. Prior to, after the motion was raised, citing her in contempt, Congressman Roger Gutierrez asked the chair to allow the witness to explain to the body why she's refusing to answer. Now, Ms. Ong, ang sinasabi lang po ni Congressman Rog, bibigyan ka ng pagkakataon, explain sa amin kung bakit mo nire-refuse yung mga simpleng tanong tulad ng saan ka nag-college na hindi naman ho talaga siya incriminating. So yun lang ho yung binibigay sa iyo para maintindihan ho namin kung bakit ayaw mong sumagot. Binibigyan ka namin ng pagkakataon, explain po sa amin. kung bakit ganyan yung asta mo na ayaw mong sagutin, maski yung mga simpleng bagay like pag tinanong kita anong favorite color mo, sabihin mo, I refuse to testify. So bakit ho ganun yung inyong asta ngayon?
Marami pong reason. Una, under oath po ako dito. And possible po siya magamit against me in the future po.
Mr. Chair, if I may.
Mr. Chair.
Hindi,
dahil hindi ka nagko-cooperate dito sa pagdinig na ito, there is now a motion upon the motion by Congressman Benny Abante to cite you again for contempt. And hearing no objections from the members of this committee, the chair rules that you are cited in contempt.
Okay.
Is there any motion?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. For the second motion, Mr. Chairman, I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the duration in which until the committee report will be adopted in the plenary, Mr. Chairman. And it follows that it will, the investigation will be terminated, Mr. Chairman.
There is a motion to detain her as long as this committee hearing of the Quadcom completes its investigation, which as of this time, as we speak, is still undetermined as to the number of days. So until we terminate, hanggang matapos itong committee hearing na to, you are cited in contempt and you will be detained as a penalty for violating Section 11 of our rules. Any second? Duly seconded. Any objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Okay. Mr. Chairman.
Next motion.
Mr. Chairman, with that, Mr. Chairman, I move that since the congressional facility for detainees is too crowded, I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the Women's Correctional Center. So move, Mr. Chairman.
There is a motion to detain Cassandra Ong at the Women's Correctional Center located at
Mandaluyong.
Mandaluyong. It's a detention facility, Women's Correctional. Duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.